Are you tired of missed investing opportunities in your life? Do you want to achieve all your financial goals in your life? Hi, hello, this is Ganesan, your millionaire coach and author of the book Money Leaks. Today, it's an interesting topic. What you will learn today is that if you're someone who dwells into the past, who keeps living in the past and says that I missed that, I missed this opportunity, if I had done that, I would have been a crorepati by now. If you're someone who dwells into the past and keeps worrying, this video is for you. And what I can assure you is that by the end of this video, you will say, what if I had done this now and I become a crorepati? What if I had done this now, I make a profit of this much amount? This is what you will get it once you go through this video towards the end. Thanks for watching. If you're watching a live video, please, thanks for watching. If you're watching a recorded version, thanks for you too. And please share this video with your friends if you had liked it. And they can also get something out of this video. They can also grab the opportunities which comes in their way. It can be investing. It can be any business decision or whatever it is. By any means, if you're getting money, you should be ready to accept it. If there is resistance, you will push away everything. You may never know, are you resisting money coming into your life? Okay, just let's get into this today's topic. Like, are you tired of missed investing opportunities? So this came to me because I was, it's long time back, I was talking to my friend and we used to work together. And at that time, I just started about learning and reading about investing and how to start, where to start. And I saved everything in my deposits and everything. So looking at my corpus, we used to discuss everything about what I had and what he has. And he said, in this short span, if you're able to save this much, I am worried because I missed so many opportunities. Because he was working for the last 10 years in IT industry and he was not able to make so much money. And he was so much worried because what I saw is that he invested fully in real estate because his father had recommended, and my father was taking care of everything and he used to have everything and fixed deposit. That is the only difference I can say, but that is what he was doing. He was dwelling into the past and worried about what he can do. And it's been more than 5-6 years, and even now it's like he keeps spending and his income and everything has changed, but the thing is he still keeps worrying about the past. And to just come over it, he just does whatever he can do with whatever money he has. He keeps spending, he keeps enjoying life like anything. So instead, how can you look at the opportunities available right now? Looking at right now, what you can do. Like, I just got a forward message and I just verified this information too. You need to check this information which is appearing right in front. Like, these are some of the mutual funds which has provided more than 15% returns in the last 15 years. If you have been investing something around 15,000 per month, you would have made 1 crore. Consider, these are funds which have started more than 15 years ago. You should have been investing 15,000. Maybe if you're working in the industry for the last 15, 20 years. And now if you check, you could have been a crorepati. You would have invested just 27 lakhs and the corpus is close to a crore. Some of the funds had crossed a crore. Sundaram and Franklin has actually crossed a crore. So this is the opportunity you had missed. Even I'm saying it to you, you had missed it. If you're not investing for the last 15 years, you had missed it, right? So let's keep this ahead because it has gone. The opportunity for the last 15 years is gone and you had accumulated in a real estate or by any other means, either in fixed deposit or put it in a PPF or so many instruments are there. You would have accumulated something, you would have saved something. What you can do in the future, I mean, right from now, what you can do instead of worrying and instead of keep spending, instead of just complaining about everybody, you know, all the complaining about the government, like the scrutiny has gone up and so much. Think about, you are invested 27 lakhs in the last 15 years and the corpus is around 1 crore. Which any other instrument which can give that much returns, you need to reconsider. And this is something safe. You are going to put the same amount in SIP mode, systematic investment planning, you're going to get it. And instead of worrying like what I had lost, just keep investing in the future. Just even if you're around 30s and 40s, this is the best time to start investing. And because government has kept a biggest target, like in the next 6 years, we are going to double, our economy is going to get doubled from $2.5 trillion, we are going to becoming $5 trillion by 2025. And by 2030, we are going to be $10 trillion economy. It's like almost like four times economy in just 10 years. See the amount of growth, what we can get. And that too in equities, the opportunity is huge. You need to be there in the equities, and that too in mutual funds. And you need to choose the right fund, because the difference between the best and the worst is huge. It may be more than 10 to 15%. You need to be with the right fund. You need to keep monitoring. You need to have the right advice. And why are the some pictures are there in the screen, right? Because instead of worrying in the past, and you need to take a decision now, because you will get aged like an... The time will flow like anything. You just completed your college, and right now think about how many years had gone working in your started working and started earning. You had kids, and you may be 30s, 40s, or even 50s. Just rewind, and you are not taken a decision to invest in equities, or you are not taken a decision to put your money or to work properly. And I had one of the friend who just keeps so much amount in fixed deposits, just because he thinks it's an emergency, and that too in a current account which is not going to yield anything. There are so many amount lying around you in your bank which is not yielding any interest. Why are you wasting something like that? You had earned a lot, and if you're not using it properly, then again, it's a waste of money. Why are you earning so much? You are earning a lakhs and lakhs of rupees, and if you're not putting it to the right use, and if it is not going to help you in your future, then what is the purpose of earning so much money? Then what is the purpose of having so much in your bank account? You need to think a lot, and you need to make your money to work for you so that it works for you. Your money should work for you. That is the reason I'm saying don't worry in the past. Don't keep things in the past. Forget it. If you had lost money in equity mutual fund or in direct equity, that is a pass. Take a wise decision. Learn about equity. Learn about mutual fund. Learn from the person who had done the best. And then ask him how to invest. How much money should I invest? Start small. And that is when financial planning helps you. You may think you are investing a lot. You may think I don't have enough money. But this is the time you should plan. Planning doesn't require any money. I think so many people, when I say let me do a financial planning for you, and then you think about investing, what they say is let me start earning this much, and I should have something to invest, right? Then I will come to you. For every one of you out there, please share this specifically. Please share this, tell them, if you are watching this, tell this to your friends, that you don't need lots of money to invest. You need a money to invest, but what I'm saying is you doesn't need money to plan. You may be saving just 10,000. You can't invest that much, because that is you need that something for emergency, right? You may not invest. You shouldn't invest that amount. What I'm saying is how much money you should plan invest for your future. You may be in your 50s and just not investing anything, and you are paying only your EMIs. You keep on paying EMIs, and nothing will be left over when you turn 60 or 65. And the thing is, you may need to keep working. If you're ready to work till your last breath, then keep working. You don't need to any planning. But still, at that time, banks will not be ready to give you any amount. And you should be having money. At that age, you can't go and ask your kids. You can't go and ask your friends. Like, I'm not having any money. You should give it something to me. That's embarrassing, right? So that is the reason I'm saying you need to plan right now. Because at 40s and 50s, banks will be ready to give any amount. If you are collateral, but at 60s you may not have any proofs, and the age is almost like 60. At that time, it's difficult for banks to give sanction an amount, right? So that is a reason you should start investing, and not investing, you should start planning right now. List down your goals. That's why I had put down a pen on the corner on your left. Take a pen right now, and this is a homework I can say, and then you can say, yes, I had list down my goals. That is the thing I'm expecting in the comment section. And if you need any help, like what are the things I need to plan? For planning, nothing is required. What do you need for if you're married and in 30s and 40s and even in 50s and 60s? You may have some bank account, you may have some bank amount balance, and you want to use it properly. put that as a financial goal. And at 60, how much amount do you need? If you're not knowing anything, put that as a financial goal, retirement corpus, and you can ask someone who is the best. And you may have a kids who are going to higher education. What is the amount you require? That can be a goal. So all these are financial goals, which comes in the future. It's not in the past. Your kids would have grown. Your income would have grown. Your kids may be growing. At least you need to plan right now, because for their higher education, there is always a home. There is always education loan available. But if they are going abroad, you may need to shell out something. You may need to show some bank balance. For that, you need some investment planning, right? So all these things requires planning, which doesn't require any amount. Only thing it's required is a mindset to start writing your goals and not worrying on the past. Equity mutual funds, I'm sure many of you would have thought ULIP as a mutual fund and then complaining that I had lost money in mutual fund. Mutual fund is different, ULIP is different. You would have got lost with the incorrect financial advice, but that shouldn't stop you from investing again, because consider you had failed in one of the class in sixth standard, and if you think that I won't write that exam again, you can't progress. You should progress, and you will start studying, right? Learn about what is a mistake you have done, what is a mistake you should avoid in the future. Only that will help in moving towards a financial freedom, or at least right planning, not the stress. Money is a reason for number one reason for stress. You may have a great job, you may have a biggest home, but with debts and improper use of money, it will cause stress in your head, and that may be the only reason for death also. So you need to, if you're having money, you should enjoy like anything, and for that, right planning and then right use of money. So that one of my friend, I will just finish off with this one. Like one of my friend, what he's asked in financial planning was that I have everything in life, I can take care of my debts, but the only thing is I'm not able to go to vacation for the last 3-4 years. I'm asking my family, and even they are not ready because they are complaining about debts. Start planning for that too. I just given the plan, and they are so happy that they will start planning to go to their vacation in the next 6 months during the holidays of their kid. So this is what can happen. Whatever you think it's a mind block, just open and say it to your financial advisor, and he'll be the right person to guide you in proper planning and investing. And if you need any help with respect to putting down your life goals or asking whom to ask, just mention it to me or send out a message. I'll be there to help you out. And that's it for now. Don't feel that I missed that opportunity. There is always a next opportunity which you should grab, and it can be because even in business you need to grab it. If you leave it, that may be the golden opportunity. Be ready, be open, don't resist money. Money can come through your business, through investments, or in any conversation. So don't resist anywhere, just be open for options, open for investing, or open for any opportunity coming in your life. And that's it for today. And if you think this video is good, and please share this video with your friends. And if you're watching it in YouTube, please subscribe to my channel. I will be posting regularly on these topics. And thanks for watching. Keep commenting on if you need any help with respect to any of the topic with respect to investments, insurance, or whatever. Thank you for watching.